Fitness News HealthBeat.
And welcome back on the Health Beat today. Some good nutrition information for your families, especially for moms, where you can find answers to questions about feeding your family right. And that's what Mary Snell is here to talk about. She's a registered dietitian for Marsh. And Mary, I know we're talking about some good resources for families because everyone wants to feed their family the right thing.
They really do.
And there are actually some books out there that can help geared toward age groups.
Right. You know, the internet is a great source of information, but sometimes we question the credibility of some of the information we get on the internet.
Sure.
So books are really helpful. And so I wanted to talk about three different books for different segments throughout kind of the lifespan.
And the first, we're talking about the youngest.
The youngest. You know, new moms, there's always questions about what should I feed my child? Is this food acceptable? And you know, there's a real interest nowadays in terms of making your own baby food. And so new parents are struggling with, okay, is it safe? How do I do it? This first book is really ideal for providing all the information that you need, from equipment to how to introduce foods, how to store it, how to prepare it, how to freeze it, all kinds of different things.
Very
written
important.
From a dietitian who also has kind of gone through that with her own kids, so I really like this book a lot for new parents.
That's great. And then that next level, you obviously want to incorporate, it's so nice to incorporate learning with the education as far as eating as well.
It really is. And again, the second book, Healthy Foods from A to Z, is really again for those toddlers who love pictures.
Okay.
And I love this book again because it basically has the different foods for the alphabet. And then on every page, there's like a face made from those different fruits and vegetables and healthy foods. And again, I like this book for, just suggesting to parents, take it with you to the grocery store and encourage the child, let's say, we're going to find all the foods that start with A today. And get them, you know, used to maneuvering through the grocery store and looking for those healthy foods that start with A today. And maybe on your next visit, look for foods that start with B, the healthy foods. So I think it's a great way to engage them with how to shop for healthy foods from an early age.
And certainly makes it fun for them.
Lots of fun. Yes.
All right, Mary, thanks. Yes. Well, then the third item we're talking about is an issue we've talked about a lot, and that's kids who are struggling with weight. And this is really a unique book with a unique perspective.
I like this book a lot because it's written from a 10-year-old who is struggling with overweight.
Okay.
And you know, and when I was that age, I struggled with being overweight as well. And I like the focus of this book because he's writing it from his perspective as a 10-year-old. And it's a journal for about 30 days and how he got his family involved in making just some small steps. It's not a diet plan by any ways, but it's learning to look at food labels, reduce portion size, and engaging the entire family in what should be really a family kind of project. And it's a wonderful book for anyone from 10 to 13-year-olds that might be struggling with weight, and this is ideal for them. So this is my third pick.
And almost something you would enjoy reading together with
your child. It's a wonderful book. There's a lot of tips from his perspective, his mom's recipes that I think kids in that age group would really enjoy. So, wonderful book.
Mary Snell, thank you so much for joining us today. Some very good resources.